Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2019 University of Maryland Terrapin Music Camp Concert! The students are so excited to be able to demonstrate for you what they've been working on this week. Yes, some of you were in this very room this past Sunday and heard around the building and heard exactly what they sounded like at that point. Well, I think you are in for a big surprise as they progressed with their excellent faculty throughout the week. I have a couple of things I would like to say before we get started. First of all, thank you for allowing us the privilege of working with your children this week. It's been an absolute, honestly, gem for me to be able to be here, and I know our faculty feel the same way. I hope the students do. We look forward to sharing with you everything that went on in our rehearsals, the outcome of that. But just a few moments ago, literally, we were in another room having a demonstration of performance of all of our elective classes, or many of our elective classes. So some of these very students, and some of those in the audience, were participating in classes like a cappella and movies, creating a soundtrack for movie groups, for composition and songwriting. Some awesome songs were created this week by your kids. Many other electives as well, including camp chorus and theater and other amazing opportunities. Our faculty, believe me, I say this and I mean it from the bottom of my heart, our faculty are the best faculty at any music camp in the state of Maryland, maybe even on the East Coast. I'm just saying that out loud to make sure you know that. I really believe that. Yes, yes. All of them are listed in the program. After the concert, the students will remain here after the concert. They will go back and get their instruments and all of their other materials, and then we'll meet you out in the lobby. So please don't come up on stage or creates a little too much commotion, and there'll be a lot of people trying to do a lot of things at that time. So they will meet you out in the lobby. You can't take photos here. We ask that you not do so when they're performing, because especially if it uses a flash, because then it's, you know, could distract them from performing. Well, anyway, please, thank you. If you want to use video, just please stay out of the aisles. Sound good? All right. Well, I'm very thankful for our conductors who have worked with us this week. Mr. Bill Rose with this 5-6-7 bit orchestra. Ms. Sarah Castro with the 8-9-10 orchestra. And Dr. Ken Elpis with the choir. You guys ready for the show? We've been ready, Dr. Bill. We've been ready. Stop talking. All right. Well, let's get going then with the 5-6-7 orchestra.
Thank you. Good afternoon. My name is Bill Rose, and I have the honor and privilege of being the director this week for the 567 Orchestra. The first piece you heard was called Sword Dance. It's very fast, very exciting. It's actually a melody from the Renaissance that's been repurposed for that arrangement. The next piece is also an older melody that has gone through several variations. The piece is called St. Anthony Chorale, and it's originally by Haydn, who took the melody and used it in Divertimento, and then later Brahms used the same melody in a theme and variations. The challenge through all of these pieces and what we've been working on this week is playing with the correct style. So we hope you hear a light, refined, and sophisticated sound in St. Anthony Chorale. Next selection is entitled Lotus Dance, and we had a fun time discussing what a lotus flower even is and what it means. So for those of you who don't know, the flower is also known as a water lily, and it grows in ponds and lakes, and it's a perennial, so it comes back year after year. There are some lotus flowers that date back 1,300 years. And it also has a lot of religious and cultural significance. You can read about the lotus in Christianity, Buddhism, Taoism. It's everywhere. And a reoccurring theme that you see is that the lotus flower is planted in mud, but grows unstained. So we talked about the metaphor of that and what that means for life. We all go through hard things, challenging things, but those are the things that help us grow. So we hope you hear water, we hope you hear growth, we hope you hear life in Lotus Dance. Thank you.
Give it up for our drummer.
Strawberry Jam Session, and it's a really fun piece, and these guys actually did something pretty cool that orchestras don't often get to do, and they learned how to play with a swing style, which comes from jazz, which is the only American art form. It's our art form, so it's cool that we got to do it in this piece and play with a swing style. Before we move on to our final selection, I just want to take a second to say thank you to Dr. Hewitt and all of the other faculty and junior faculty at this wonderful camp. They're excellent educators and educators-to-be, and they're an inspiration to work with, so please give them a round of applause. I'd like to quickly thank you, the parents, for valuing the role of music education in your children's lives. You did not have to be here, you did not have to come, but you are, you care, and these guys couldn't do it without your support and your time and your money and your effort and your love. So give yourselves a round of applause, please. And last but not least, I have to thank these awesome kids. I put them through the ringer. That's right, give them a round of applause. These guys showed up every day to rehearsal, focused, ready to work, ready to have fun. And we had a talk where we realized that there are, I think, about 60 people in this group who most of them don't know each other. We kind of all come from different parts, you know? We might not run into each other at the grocery store, and somehow, in a few short days, we're making music together. You know, that's a pretty powerful thing to form a community where there wasn't one before, and that's one of the beautiful things about making music and being in music. So whether you end up being a lifelong musician or not, Oh no, I'm sorry, professional musician. You're definitely going to be a lifelong musician. And I just want to say thank you for being here. It's been an honor and a joy to teach you, and I've learned so much from you. I hope you learned something from me. And with that being said, we're going to conclude with a finale from Serenade for Strings by Tchaikovsky. This is a really cool piece. Tchaikovsky wrote the middle part of it as an homage to Mozart, so we get to work on a bunch of different styles. Tchaikovsky was known for being big and epic and melodious, and Mozart was that light, refined style, so Tchaikovsky does a cool thing blending the two in this final movement for his Serenade for Strings. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us today, for sharing your children with us this week. We've got one more for you. It's Turn the World Around by Harry Belafonte. And we've done a lot to this particular arrangement, and I would like to acknowledge our camp administrator, and you've seen him play about 7 different instruments tonight, Adam Brzee. Adam did a lot of the arranging for, a lot of what you heard tonight, so today, I don't know what time it is. So thank you so much for joining us. This is our final tune.